ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد We begin with the thanks and the praises of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, praising Him and thanking Him subhanahu wa ta'ala for allowing us to come on this blessed day of Jumu'ah, for allowing us to come on this blessed day to worship Him the way that He has commanded us to worship Him. Because it is necessary for us to realize that our worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not out of our own volition. Rather, He has chosen for us to be here, and He has given us the ability to worship Him. And so for the very ability we have to worship Him, we need to thank Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one way of thanking Him is through shukr. And another way of thanking Him is through the ittiba', through the following, through the holding tight, and firm holding onto the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And so one of the sunnahs of the Prophet ﷺ, he describes the jama'ah, he describes the mu'mineen, he describes the believers in multiple ways, but one of the ways that he describes them is he describes them as one body. He describes them as brothers that go beyond brothers of blood, but brothers of faith. Brothers, that it doesn't matter which tribe or country you're from, it doesn't matter what sect you belong to, but because you say, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, you are closer to me than anyone else. And you are more sacred to me than the Ka'bah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala itself. And so one of the ways that we show this love between one another is in a famous saying, Man wasala safan wasalahullah. Whoever approaches the Sufuf, the lines of prayer, he is the one who is going to reach Allah. So out of the adab and out of the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I ask everyone to come closer, to come to the front sufuf. Come close to your brothers. Come forward and join the mercy and the angels that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed up here. This is where the mercy and the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. At His highest. He encompasses this entire place in His mercy and forgiveness, but in the front and closest is where He places His most of His mercy and most of His forgiveness. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he would begin his prayers, would walk through the lines of the prayers. And he would take his hand and make sure that the shoulders are lined together, like a brick wall. That there's no space, such that it seemed as if the Sahaba were uncomfortable in their prayer, being so squished together in their prayer that their skin, that their shoulders are being smushed with the shoulders to the people next to them. But in that moment is when we hear the stories of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum about the khushu that they had. That is when we hear that the Sahaba radiallahu anhum used to see it as if Allah was in front of them and that paradise and hell were to their right and left. They used to act as if they were out of this dunya. But the sabab, the means to that actualization is to show it in this world by the coming together of the mu'mineen. So when we stand strong and we stand firm. We all know the famous example of what happens when of the believers being one body. And we all have faced the greatest enemy, not Shaitan, but the greatest enemy the corner of the couch or the table. Oh, when you bang your pinky toe on that, you're done. Everyone knows that pain, and no one wants to ever experience it again, but it always happens. And just the pain in a pinky toe causes your entire body to ache. So it is as if the mu'mineen are one body. If our pinky toe hurts, our entire body is in agony. So to prevent that, we must be like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, signaled with his hands like this, firm, strong together. And so now let's examine, inshaAllah, what is it that prevents this from us? We know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all wise. We know that He is all knowledgeable. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran places certain ayat paired with certain other ayat. So famously, everyone knows that whenever you read something like Aqimus Salah, you're going to have Wa Atu Zakah. Other places Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts the worship of Allah alone. And what does He pair with it? Being good to your parents. To raise the status of birrul walidain, He places it with the tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of Himself. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in an ayah that we all hear every single week at the Jumu'ah Khutbah, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu taqullaha haqqa tuqatih wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. Just for a moment, let's analyze this ayah. O believers, so He is talking to us subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's talking to you and you and you and you. Do not imagine that these addresses to us are as if, oh, it's going to the Sahaba, oh, it's just another ayah in the Quran. No, this Quran was sent to you. Ya fulan, ya mu'min, ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, ittaqullaha haqqa tuqatih. Have this honest, this fear, this taqwa of Allah, as is His right. Subhanallah. As is His right. Can anyone claim to say that they fear Allah, that they have the taqwa of Allah, that they have the awe of Allah, as is the right of Allah? Subhanallah. The Sahaba heard this and they were shook. How do you do this, Ya Rasulullah? So He consoled them. And another ayah came down and He told them, do as much as you can. وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. And do not die except as believers. So this very powerful ayah, extremely powerful, have taqwa of Allah as is His right. What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pair it with? وَاَعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. That hold tightly unto the rope of Allah and do not be divided amongst yourselves. وَاذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ. And remember the ni'mah of Allah upon you. إِذْ كُنْتُمْ أَعْدَاءً فَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ فَأَصْبَحْتُمْ بِنِعْمَتِهِ إِخْوَانًا. That you were once divided and that division caused you to be on the edge of a fire of the Jahannam. But He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, pulled you back and He united your hearts, making you ikhwana, making you brothers. This is a ni'mah of Allah. So when we look left and right and we see, oh, that guy's a little awkward, I'm not really inclined to talk to so and so. That person slighted me this one time. That person, this excuse. That person, that excuse. That person, that excuse. Especially when it gets into jealousy and lying and deceit. Oh, this person does this and this person does this. When we get into these things, we're being divided, and this is the tool of the shaitan. So it is our obligation to remove this hate from our hearts. It is absolutely necessary that we remove that hate from our hearts. And once that hate is removed, then we can become this ikhwan. So when we see these individuals, because some people will say, I hate him, but you don't get it. Right? You just don't get it. This guy, he... And then so on and so forth. You just don't get it with this guy. This person, my situation is different. We always come up with these excuses, so we need to ask ourselves and ask yourselves this. What is it that causes you to hate so and so? Is the reason that you hate such and such person because of a divine purpose? That you hate them because you have anger for them, because you have restraint away and you stay away from them because they disobey Allah in a certain way. They take the rights of other people away. They are known to be deceivers and they are known to be fasiqoon. Is that the reason you hate them? Or is the reason something nafsi? Is it something within our hearts that we hate them for? Is it a cultural reason? Is it a religious reason? Is it an intellectual reason? Oh, he's too smart. Oh, he's too dumb. Or is it that we just don't share any interests? Inshallah, I'll try to be quick. Whenever we watch a movie, we always see that nerdy kid, the weird one, who's sitting by himself at the lunch table, but everyone's always cheering him on. Everyone wants that kid to come out on top. But he's always the one by himself. He's always the one who's sitting alone. He's always the one that has no friends. When we see it in the movie, we always want him to win. When it happens in our cafeterias, oh no, that's just a weird kid. What's the difference? What's the difference in the two situations? It's the same situation. In one situation, we want to help the kid, but in the other situation, when we're actually in the shoes of the cool crowd, then that kid is just weird and he's isolated. The difference is that in the movie, they introduce us to that kid. They tell us his backstory. They tell us what struggles he's went through. They tell us what secret powers he has. They tell us what potential that he carries within himself. They show us that this is not just an ordinary kid. No, this is some sort of hero. This is some sort of superhero. This is some sort of master. They just don't know it. So those kids that are sitting alone, those kids that have no friends, the only reason, and I promise you, the only reason you do not like them is because you do not know who they are. Every person that you hate, you dislike, you may have known them for 20, 30, 40 years, but do you know their story? Do you know what they went through? Do you know what it is that they had to struggle with? We don't know these people. And in order to build this bond of ikhwana, to have this وَذْكُرُ نِعْمَةُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ, to remind ourselves of this ni'mah of Allah upon us, it is our duty to get to know these people. So inshallah, we make the intention to do this, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give His providential hand in our assisting us. استغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه انه هو الغفور. الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه وسلم. The last point I'm just going to end with, and it's going to be homework. You won't be tested on it, you won't be graded on it. But it's just something to think about. One of my teachers said that the times that we live in now, specifically our times, we live in what he called was the madhab of Iblis. It is the pathway, the tradition, the following of Iblis, of Shaytan. And so we have our own creed that we hold on to. So our creedal statement, everyone knows this, alhamdulillah, is what makes us Muslims. Our creedal statement is, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. What's the creedal statement of Iblis? That brings you into his madhab, that brings you into his deen. So my teacher said that his statement is, Ana khayrun min, that I am better than so-and-so. If ever in our hearts we begin to think, Ana khayrun min, that I am better than this person, or I am better than this person, or I am better than this person, know that you are on what deen? The deen of Iblis. These are the words that he said to create his own religion. These are the words that he said when he disobeyed Allah. These are the words that distinguished him from all of the angels that surrounded the heavens, prostrating to Adam alayhi salam. This is what isolated him. Who do we want to be with when we say ana khayr, when we interact with people? Do we want to say ana khayrun min and be on Iblis' side? Or do we want to be the people of La ilaha illallah and be with the angels and be with the anbiya and be on the side that we know in the next world is going to be victorious? So just reflect in all of our interactions that we have with people, whether it be your little siblings, whether it be your parents. And it's easy when it's someone you don't know. It's easy when it's the waiter at the restaurant. What is those people close to you when you're interacting with them? Are you saying that I know better than you? Oh, kids say this all the time. I know better than my parents. They don't understand me. They don't know what I'm going through. What are you saying? Ana khayrun min. Bring about humility to be on the side of Allah, to be on the side of His messengers, and inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant us victory in this life and in the life to come. الحمد لله استغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه انه هو الغفور الرحيم اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا وعافنا واعف عنا اللهم ادخلنا الجنه مع النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن اولئك ورفيقا واعذنا من عذاب القبر ومن عذاب جهنم ومن عذاب الحشر ومن عذاب الميزان استغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين واخر السلام